हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. वंस अगेन कमिंग बैक टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स. लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ लेट्स पिक अप विद द लास्ट टॉपिक, मेडिकल एंटोमोलॉजी. सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी लर्न अबाउट हाउ द एंटोमोलॉजी इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इन मेडिकल फील्ड, हाउ दे आर इम्पॉर्टेंट इन ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिसीजेस, वॉट आर द थ्री डिफरेंट मोड्स ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल ट्रांसमिशन, what is propagative, cyclopropagative and cyclodevelopmental. Okay, now let's start with what are different arthropod vectors of the diseases and what are the diseases transmitted by them. Okay, so students, remember this is one of the most important slides as far as your NEET preparation examination is considered and as far as your practical vivas and spots are considered. Okay, so please pay attention and please remember this is the most important slide. The mosquitoes, they transmit the diseases malaria, filaria, viral encephalitis, that is Japanese encephalitis, viral fevers like dengue, West Nile fever, viral hemorrhagic fever, yellow fever and dengue hemorrhagic fever. Okay, so about mosquito, there are three most important species of mosquito. We will come to that later. And these three species, they transmit these different diseases. Okay, housefly or common housefly transmits typhoid and paratyphoid fever, diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, gastroenteritis, amoebiasis, helminthic infestation, poliomyelitis, conjunctivitis, trachoma, anthrax, yaws, etc. Okay, so basically it transmits either fecal-orally transmitted diseases or some direct contact transmitted diseases. Sandfly is one of the most important vector which transmits kala azar or also known as leishmaniasis. It also transmits oriental sore, sandfly fever and oraya fever. Tsetse fly, it transmits sleeping sickness. Louse, the body louse or head louse transmits epidemic typhus, relapsing fever, trench fever and pediculosis. Pediculosis is nothing but head lice infestation. Rat flea, the again most important spots specimen which will be given to you as your spots. And remember, rat flea, it transmits bubonic plague, endemic typhus, chagirrhosis and hymenolopis diminuta. Okay, so remember, we will ask you to identify rat flea and then we will ask you which are the diseases transmitted by it. Okay, so these are the rest of the arthropods and diseases transmitted by them. Remember, itch mite is the disease caused by itch mite is scabies, and that is the direct cause of disease is the vector, it is the insect itself. Okay, so it doesn't act as a vector of the disease, it acts as a causative agent. Okay, rest of the most of the all other arthropod vectors, they act as a medium to transmit the disease from diseased person to the susceptible host. Okay, but this most important insect, itch mite or scabies, and the louse which causes pediculosis or other infections. So the pediculosis is infestation with the head louse. Okay, and itch mite is the infestation of itch mite, which we call it as a scabies. Then cyclops, which is found in water, it transmits guinea worm disease and fish tapeworm. And cockroaches, they also transmit fecal-oral transmitted diseases or enteric pathogens. Okay, now if we are talking about a causative agent, disease transmitted by them, and vectors which are responsible for these diseases, then viruses and the diseases transmitted from through the agent of viruses are yellow fever, dengue hemorrhagic fever, chikungunya, West Nile fever, Japanese encephalitis, phlebotomous fever, and Kayasunor forest disease. The vectors can be mosquitoes, sandfly, and arctic. Rickettsial diseases like epidemic typhus, trench fever, endemic typhus, tick typhus, Q fever, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, rickettsial pox, and scrub typhus. The rickettsial fever, which is most prevalent in Ahmednagar district, okay, and which is diagnosed by Well-Felix test, and there are n number of vectors. Okay, so these are the most common vectors: louse, rat flea, tick, arctic, soft tick, and mite. So all these kind of insects, small insects which sit on pigs, which sit and feed on cattles and dogs and cats, they can also affect human beings in terms of this rickettsial fever. Okay. So remember, whenever you are doing your internship postings, do remember that rickettsial fever, they can be transmitted through all kinds of insects, louse, rat flea, tick, mites, and diagnosed by Welfelix test. And a clinical presentation will be high grade fever, rash, and typical Welfelix positive test. The bacterial diseases like typhoid, cholera, shigellosis, plague can be transmitted by housefly or plague by rat flea, and other diseases. So coming to the mosquitoes, we have four important groups of mosquitoes in India: Anopheles, Culex, Aedes, and Mansonia. Most of today's lecture will be dependent on the mosquitoes. Okay. So the adult mosquitoes of Culex, Anopheles, and Aedes, as you can see, they have a typical morphological feature and typical feature to sit on the skin and also to bite. Okay. So Aedes, as you can see, also known as tiger mosquitoes, has got black and white stripes on its body and legs. Culex mosquito sits horizontally on the body, on the host, and Anopheles sits at an angle. There are three parts in the body of mosquito: head, thorax, and abdomen. Head has a pair of large compound eyes, large proboscis, with which mosquito bites, a pair of palpi on other sides of proboscis. Palpi are like feathers of a bird, and a pair of antennae. A male has got bushy antennae and female less bushy antennae. Thorax, a pair of wings dorsally and three pairs of legs ventrally. Abdomen has got 10 segments, the last two modified to form external genitalia. So these are the specific features of Anopheline mosquitoes, which includes Anopheles, and Culicine mosquitoes, which includes Culex, Aedes, and Mansonia. Okay. So remember, there is a difference between these Anopheles mosquito and other mosquitoes in terms of eggs, which are laid singly in Anopheles mosquito, while they are laid in clusters or rafts, each raft containing 100 to 250 eggs, except Aedes mosquito. So Culex and Mansonia, they will lay eggs in 100 and 250. The eggs of Anopheles are boat-shaped and provided with lateral floats, while Culex, Aedes, Mansonia eggs are oval-shaped and not provided with lateral floats. Okay. So again, remember these things you have to rectify for your entrance examinations, okay, and also for your vivas. The larvae of Anopheles mosquito, they rest parallel to the water surface, while the adults, they rest inclined at an angle to the surface. Okay, so remember, larvae of Anopheles rest parallel to water surface, but the adults at rest are at inclined angle. The larvae of Culex and Aedes mansonia are suspended with head downwards at an angle to the water surface. The siphon tube is present in the larvae of Culex, Aedes, and mansonia, and no palmate hairs. While larvae of Anopheles, there is no siphon tube and there are palmate hairs present on abdominal segments. The pupae of Anopheles siphon tube is broad and short, while pupae of Culicine, the siphon tube is long and narrow. Adults, again, as I have already told, Anopheles adults at rest inclined at an angle, and wings of Anopheles are spotted and palpi are long in both the genders. While Culicine, when at rest, the body exhibits a hunchback, wings are unspotted and palpi are short in female. The life cycle of mosquito, like most of the other insects, is start with eggs, larva, pupa, and adult. In more detail, the life cycle of mosquito and the parasitic life cycle of malarial parasite in mosquito and human beings will be taught to you in your parasitology lectures. The Anopheles species, we have Anopheles culicifaces, which causes rural malaria, as it is more common in rural areas. Anopheles fluvitalis, found in forest and fringes. Anopheles stephensi, it causes urban malaria. And Anopheles dirus and Anopheles minimus. So remember, Anopheles culicifaces is a rural malaria and Anopheles stephensi is a urban malaria. Again, a favorite question of examiners. Diseases caused by Anopheles are malaria and filaria, but filaria is caused outside India. It sits at 45 degree water degree angle, and fresh water breeding is seen in Anopheles. So this is a 45 degree angle, classical 45 degree angle of Anopheles mosquito. Culex, also known as nuisance mosquito. Why? I'll tell you that. Species, Culex fatigans. And diseases transmitted are Brancopian filariasis, Japanese encephalitis, and West Nile fever. The rapid urbanization and industrialization without adequate drainage are responsible for its spread. It breeds in dirty water collection. The flight range is alone around 11 kilometers, has got longest flight range. The hunchback appearance is seen in adults. So this is a typical hunchback appearance of Culex mosquito. Why it is known as nuisance mosquito? Most of you have remembered some mosquito doing gwee around your head and in front of your ears. So that gwee, which is done by these mosquitoes, the typical mosquito is Culex. That is the nuisance which it causes by the fluttering of its wings. The Aedes mosquito has got white stripes on black body. That is why it is also known as tiger mosquito. The species is Aedes aegypti, Aedes vitatus, and Aedes albopictus. The diseases transmitted are dengue hemorrhagic fever, yellow fever, and filariasis, but it is outside India. Okay. So as you must have noticed, filariasis is the disease which is transmitted by all four types of mosquito. Okay. It is transmitted by Anopheles. This is just like filariasis, but it is outside India. Then again by Culex. So in India, Bancroftian filariasis is transmitted by Culex, and also Aedes, it can transmit filariasis, but outside India. So this is a Aedes mosquito, typical tiger mosquito look with white and black stripes on the body and also on the legs. The Aedes mosquito, they are abundant during rainy and just post rainy season, breeds in artificial accumulation of water, tin, broken bottles, etc., lay eggs singly in cigar shaped. Bites during the daytime, and the flight range is little less. It is just 100 meters. That's why it lays its egg near the human residence. Okay, so small collection of water, even 1 ml of water collection can be sufficient for the Aedes mosquito to lay its eggs. Okay, the Aedes aegypti index is nothing but percentage of houses showing breeding of Aedes larva. Up to 400 meter area around the airport and around seaports should not have any Aedes aegypti breeding site. Okay, and the Aedes aegypti index, that is percentage of houses showing breeding of Aedes larva, should be less than 1%. Say for example, there are 100 houses near the Mumbai airport. Okay, of 400 meter area near the Mumbai airport. Okay, and if out of those 100 houses, there are 2 houses which has been detected with Aedes aegypti breeding sites. Okay, so that Aedes aegypti index will be 2%, and it is not allowed. The feeding habit of Aedes female are hematophagous. Feeding habit of all the mosquitoes, only the female are hematophagous. Okay, they require blood meal, while the male, they survive on plant juices. Why do the female require blood meal? Because they need more nutrition, more proteins for laying eggs. Okay, the time of breeding, mostly evening or early part of night, but except Aedes mosquito, which feeds throughout the day or during the day. Resting habit, rest during the day in dark and cool corners. Breeding habits, Anopheles, clean water, Culex, dirty polluted water, and Aedes in artificial water collections. Mansonia, water containing aquatic vegetation. What is hibernation? The adult mosquito hibernate in unfavorable conditions like extreme winter. The dispersal generally do not fly from breeding place except Culex mosquito, which can fly up to 11 kilometers. Lifespan varies from 8 to 34 days and influenced by temperature and humidity. The male's mosquito are short-lived. The mosquito control measures, we can apply anti-larval measures, anti-adult measures, and protection against mosquito bites. Okay, anti-larval measures are environmental control, chemical and biological control. Anti-adult measures are residual spray, space spray, and genetic control, and protection by mosquito nets, screening, and repellents. What are anti-larval measures? The environmental control includes to eliminate the breeding places or source reduction. Okay, so like I have already explained, the Aedes mosquito can breed in just 1 ml collection of water near the house. Okay, so we should remove all, even the smallest collection of water in and around the houses. And we should also follow the 7-day dry day rule. Okay, so every seventh day, all the water collections which can be there, artificial water collections which have to be there in and around houses, typically in the slum areas, we advise them to empty those water collections, big tanks or big large buckets and all, and then keep them dry for one day. Okay, even one single ml of water should not be there, which will be sufficient for Aedes mosquito to grow and to spread the dengue disease. Okay, the source reduction comprises minor engineering methods such as filling, leveling and drainage of breeding places and water management. Now, chemical control for anti-larval, we have commonly used larvicides as mineral oil, Paris green and synthetic insecticides. Mineral oils, when applied on water, the oil spreads and forms a thin film which cuts off the air supply of the mosquito larvae and pupae. Example, mosquito larvicidal oil, fuel oil or even diesel or kerosene. Paris green, the chemical composition is copper acetoarsenite. It acts as a stomach poison to these larvae and mainly kills Anopheles larvae because they are surface feeders. The synthetic insecticides like Fenthion, Chlorpyrifos and Abate can be used as a chemical agent. Now, how can we do biological control of larva? There are some fish which specifically breed, feed on these mosquito larva like Gambusia affinis and Labister reticulatus. These fishes, they feed on these larva and pupa of mosquitoes, thus reducing the number of larvae or eliminating the larvae in these water collections and thus biological control. Anti-adult measures, we have residual sprays, DDT most commonly used, Malathion, Propoxer, Lindane and space sprays like sprayed as a mist or fog. Pyrethrum extract and pyrethrin, which is the active principle, acts as a nerve poison. The genetic control of these adults can be done by releasing sterile males into the wild. Cytoplasmic incompatibility and chromosomal translocations and sex distortion. Now, in brief, we will go through the houseflies. The important species of housefly, these are Musca domestica, which is most common. Also, Musca vicinia or Nebulo can be found. The Musca domestica is our common housefly or everyday housefly which we see in our houses or nearby areas. General characteristics, they are mouse gray in color. Body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen like mosquitoes. The head has got a pair of antennae and a pair of large compound eyes. Retractile proboscis or for sucking liquid foods is present. Okay, so remember, flies, they suck the liquid food. Okay, so and this is the most important reason for transmission of diseases, picoral diseases through these flies. How exactly, we'll come to that soon. Thorax is marked with 2 to 4 dark longitudinal stripes, which is characteristic of genus Musca. A pair of wings and 3 pair of legs, covered with numerous short and stiff hairs known as pinnate hairs. Abdomen has got segmented and shows light and dark markings. Okay, the life cycle of housefly is egg, first, second and third larval stage, pupa and then adult fly. The transmission of diseases are typhoid, paratyphoid fever, diarrhea and dysentery, cholera, gastroenteritis, other picorally transmitted parasitic diseases, etc. Mode of transmission is either mechanical, vomit, drop or defecation. So what happens is, as I have already explained, they have got a retractile proboscis for sucking of liquid foods. Okay, so what do they do is, whenever they are on their food, which is mostly solid in nature, they will secrete the larva, they will spit the larva through this proboscis on that food. Okay, and this larva contains enzymes which will liquefy that solid food. After liquefying the food, it will suck that larva, suck that food, liquid food material again through the proboscis. Okay, so what happens when there is open defecation or whenever there is a very high contaminated waste outside nearby homes or nearby eateries, nearby hotels? What happens is these larvae sit on that fecal matter. These larvae then secrete their enzymatic juices on that fecal matter. The fecal matter gets dissolved, converts into liquid, and then again they suck that fecal matter inside. Then again they go and sit on the nearby food eateries where the food is open, where the gulab jamun, samosa and vadas are open, and flies are sitting on them. And what they will do after coming from that fecal meal, they will again sit on that gulab jamun. They will release their enzymatic juices on that gulab jamun, and along with that juices, that fecal matter which they have just sat on will also again go on that food material. Okay, and that's how the diseases gets transmitted. So not only this process, they will also transmit this fecal transmitted diseases through mechanical transmission. Okay, so all the pairs of these flies, all the three pairs of legs, all the six legs will also contain some disease causing agent, and also defecation. So they will not only just sit on the gulab jamun, they will eat vomit and eat the same from the gulab jamun, they will also defecate on the gulab jamun. So all these three types of transmission takes place through these flies. The control measures, environmental control, can be done by storing garbage and kitchen waste in bins with tight lids, provision of sanitary latrines, and stopping open air defecation. Okay, so most important part is the stoppage of open air defecation. Insecticidal control, the residual sprays like DDT, lindane, malathion, phenethone can be used. Space sprays like pyrethrin, DDT, HCH can be used. Larvicide like diazion and dimethoate can also be used. Now, fly papers, they contain resin and castor oil applied to the stripes of wire and hung up in places where flies are around. These flies will get stuck on these fly papers and they will die. The protection against flies can be done by screening of houses. The windows should be, we use a screen for the windows. Also hospitals and food markets. If they are displaying food material, it should be displayed in a closed glass cabins or glass jars, or they can just put a fly screen over the food. The health education of general public is very important to educate them regarding disease transmission and fly awareness. Now, in brief about sandfly. Sandfly has got three parts of the body: head, thorax, and abdomen. Head bears a pair of long, slender, hairy antennae and palpi and proboscis. Thorax has got a pair of wings and three pairs of legs. Wings are densely hairy and legs are very long out of proportion of body. Abdomen has got 10 segments and covered by hairs. This is the morphology of the sandfly. Okay, so it has got a pair of wings, a hair, antennae, proboscis, thorax, and abdomen. The legs are usually longer than body. Okay, so how to differentiate between the sandfly and mosquito? In sandfly, the legs are usually longer than the body. Only females of sandfly, they bite mostly during the night. Bite is irritating and painful. Dark place holes, crevices in walls and trees are the most important places where these sandflies will live. Diseases transmitted, the most important disease is a Kala Azar or Leishmaniasis. The species responsible is Phlebotomus argentipes. The Phlebotomus papatici will also transmit sandfly fever and oriental sore. Phlebotomus sergenti will transmit oriental sore, and Phlebotomus punjabensis will transmit sandfly fever. Okay, so remember, Kala Azar, sandfly fever, oriental sore, and sandfly fever are all transmitted by sandflies. And the bite of sandfly is very irritating, and sometimes it can lead to the hypersensitivity reaction and local hypersensitivity skin reaction, leading to large lesions. Controls can be done by insecticides, DDT and lindane, or sanitation by removal of shrubs and vegetation, filling up of cracks and crevices in the walls and floors. Okay, so in this lecture, we have covered these mosquitoes, housefly, sandfly, and what are the diseases transmitted by these arthropods. Mosquito, most important, malaria, viral encephalitis, viral fever, dengue, chikungunya fever, and filariasis can be transmitted by all types of mosquitoes. But mostly in India, filariasis is transmitted by Culex. Housefly transmits all types of the fecally transmitted diseases, and the three most important types of transmission are by mechanical transmission, by vomiting, and by defecation on the food material. And sandfly, the most important disease I want you all to remember is Kala Azar. And that's it regarding today's topic. So we will continue with the third part of entomology lectures in our next session. That's it for today. Thank you.